In this lecture, we'll talk about other endocrine tissues. So we've talked about the main endocrine glands in the previous lectures, some that are regulated by the hypothalamus and pituitary, some that are not regulated by the hypothalamus and pituitary. And then these kind of fall into another class where these are tissues that have and organs that have other main functions, but they also have an endocrine component. And so we'll talk about the GI tract, the gastrointestinal tract, the placenta, the kidneys, the heart, and adipose tissue. So these other endocrine tissues that are not regulated by the hypothalamus and pituitary are going to be regulated by other kinds of stimuli, like circulating levels of nutrients, circulating levels of oxygen. Blood pressure is another thing that can regulate these tissues. And many of them may still then feed back on the hypothalamus and pituitary and other endocrine glands, but their main stimulus that drives them to secrete is not going to be derived from the anterior or posterior pituitaries. The gastrointestinal tract has several hormones that I want to tell you about. It secretes gastrin, and gastrin stimulates other gastric secretions and gut motility. And in the last couple of years, they've discovered glucose-dependent insulinotropic peptide, or GIP. And GIP is secreted by the gut and stimulates insulin release from the pancreas. Two more hormones that are secreted from the GI tract are secretin, and secretin stimulates the exocrine pancreas and bile secretion from the liver, and cholecystokinin, which, by the way, just because I'm a neuro person, is also used as a neurotransmitter. Cholecystokinin, or CCK, also stimulates the exocrine pancreas and stimulates the gallbladder to secrete bile into the small intestine. It also feeds back up onto the hypothalamus and contributes to your feeling full or feeling like you've had enough to eat. In the next segment, we'll talk about some more of these non-traditional endocrine tissues.